a typical, totally inconspicuous outfit for corporate agents. Cool. That's better than what I was wearing, I think. It looks better anyway. Oh, here! Not in the journal, but alongside it. Where's the one we picked up? New release, brand new. Yeah, I don't know. I think I read this already. Yeah, so you guys can read it if you want. I mean, maybe I didn't, it just seems familiar. I'm sure we'll find duplicates. Hi.
Why's everyone got it out for me?
That's a very good question. One which I cannot answer. I like it.
Give us incomplete info again.
Money. I like the song. Kendachi, new spring catalog. Kenshiri Adachi Armaments. Our mission. At Kendachi, we are creators. We care about our customers' satisfaction and their budget. By choosing our products, you can be confident no euro dollar invested goes to waste. Kendachi, the choice is obvious. Our products, Kendachi M55 Power Sword. Sounds cool. For our blade buffs, our iconic Power Sword is back and better than ever. Dice your foes into tiny pieces without breaking a sweat. Using our latest micro-serrated crystal blade technology with highest quality materials crafted into a lethal yet elegant design, the Power Sword will look as good on your mantle as it does in your hand. Kendachi Mono 2 Classic. You can improve upon perfection. This time-honored twin blade has been in continuous production since 2019. Lit by a custom color handle embedded laser. The Mono... Mono 2 has never gone out of style. It's hard for me to... I thought it was Mana for a second. The A's and the O's are very... It's hard to tell them, yeah. It's kind of a subtle difference. Block every blow and slice through any defense. We wouldn't keep making them if people weren't buying them. Order yours today. Kendachi Mono Wire. A weapon as discreet as it is deadly, made for those who desire power but have no urge to flaunt it. This molecule-thin blade is manufactured by our team of expert engineers in our state-of-the-art orbital facility. The mono wire can bear loads of up to 3,000 pounds and slices through armor weaves like butter-flavored scap spread. I guess that's like butter? Rumor is... Many officials at the Zurich convention wanted this weapon banned and off the market. Now, if that's not high praise, we don't know what is. I should look around a little.
I'm collecting these. I got seven.
Okay. Oh yeah, I can talk to her more. She's cute. You enjoy working the afterlife?
How's the afterlife? Working on you. No real complaints. Fights are rare, and when they do happen, they're over quick.
Killer clientele.
No words, not mine.
Meh. How's business?
This is booming, I hope.
Seen it yourself. Can't complain. Folks always get thirsty, and we're here when they do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll have a drink.
Could definitely go for a drink.
Tough day?
Like any other.
About to get tougher.
So, what'll it be? Sure.
I already stole one of those. Or picked up someone else's. Yeah, people get drunk, they leave their drinks all over. Brosef Ale. An ale of beer. Real fruit. Imagine going to a bar and just buying fruit. Easy beef. I don't know if I'm gonna... That doesn't look too appetizing. Spunky Monkey. We're going bananas for high fructose corn syrup, are you? Spunky Monkey Mint. For a minty punch to the face. I'll have a Spunky Monkey. Thanks. Oh, you know what?
Could definitely go for a drink.
Sell my junk here.
Tough day?
Like any other.
So, what'll it be?
It'll be you taking my stuff. 924 euro dollars. Sweet. This is all my stuff. Can you believe this? All this crap I pick up. The baseball cap is currently still equipped, even though it's not visible. All the muddy fleets are better. Just gonna sell a few more things. Be right back, guys, because you'll be bored watching this. Okay. Sold a lot of things. Thanks.
Thanks, Claire.
No problem. Just holler if you need anything.
Okay. I'm finding more stuff to sell to her. Let me go that way.
Show first. Not terribly subtle. Want to show everyone his boss. Old man Arasaka might as well have walked into Meyer's office naked, waving his half-shriveled dick around. Not going to start a war with this stupid aircraft carrier. No. They want to remind Militech they've got 100 more in Japan. Pacific ain't the level playing field it used to be. Goro Arasaka's not gonna pick another fight with Militech. How do you know? Did he tell you personally?
That looks awesome. Got the same kind of texting we do now. Bluegrass? Or is another shard here? Who knew this place would be like a veritable library? Okay. Who is Lizzie Wizzy pretending to be? We are who we pretend to be. I've pretended to be everything. That's why I found the truth. Lizzie Wizzy is an artist par excellence. Her work includes award-winning albums and concert tours, film appearances, as well as, for lack of a better term, conceptual performance art. Her latest artistic obsession features the medium of brain dance. In recent interviews, Lizzie has mused about the boundary between our documentation of reality versus our active shaping of it. Could that mean Lizzie Wizzy plans to scroll her own BD? We can only dream. The chance to live just one day in her chrome skin, fans would go wild. Well, good for them. How you doing?
Hey, how's it going?
Not bad. I just want to look around this place thoroughly before we leave. Are you the janitor?
Mind your damn business, yeah?
Figured you were the janitor. You got a broom. I'll help you clean up a little bit. What is that? Oh, cigarettes. The Maxed Hack Way by Matthias Maddox. Actually, if I go like this, wait. This one's not jumping out at me. That we have it. Forward to the second edition. I was fortunate, after publishing the first edition of this book, to meet many people with fascinating stories. I spoke with people who lost loved ones at the hands of cyber psychos. I met the relatives of people whom I shot. Needless to say, not every conversation ended on good terms. After some time, I learned what questions to expect from my readers. Have you ever been shot? Yes, and I've lost count. Who is the most difficult person to kill or arrest? The 2063 Golden Springs Mall Killer. More titanium bone and synth skin than man. What causes cyberpsychosis? I'll let you know when I find out. Then, at a book signing in Haywood, I was asked a question I had never heard before. Is there anything that keeps me awake at night? After a moment's reflection, I realized the answer was yes. Perhaps most surprisingly, however... hold on, guys. Okay, sorry about that. Was there music playing before? It stopped. Perhaps most surprisingly, however, it was not nightmares of eviscerated cyberpsycho victims, nor the shrieks and cries of my squad mates as they burned alive. Cruel as it may sound, I grew used to that. It was just part of the job. What caused my heart to pound as I lie in bed late at night is the thought that one day I, too, could succumb to cyberpsychosis. The amount of cyberware I have incorporated into my body is substantial. Far more than most. I tried to drown the human parts of me that fear, that doubt. I am aware just how fragile my humanity is, that piece of myself deep within that makes me who I am. One poorly clipped neuron, one hormonal overdose, and that piece may disappear forever, leaving behind an automaton with only one desire, to kill. In truth, I forced my mind to race so that I would not have to confront these thoughts. Today, I still struggle with these demons, but I have asked my wife to keep a loaded pistol in her bedside table. If I begin to scream or rant incoherently in the middle of the night, I instructed her to empty the entire clip between my eyes. At first she objected, but our love is strong. It is thanks to my loving wife's promise that I have never slept as soundly as I do now. Yeah, knowing that she'll just kill you because you'll go insane. Sorry, I had to get this guitar pick.
What's up, girl?
I want... get that, not talk. Fresh kneecaps. What's with the staplers? What are you people stapling? Ooh, dark chocolate. Camo Western Fringe Vest. In the shadows of mega buildings. One could say we're living in stable times. The Fourth Corporate War is ancient history, the Unification War is over and done with, and Night City is a free city, a jewel embedded between two Californias. Living here, you might have the impression that everything is okay in the world, but look around. The world is not okay. Despite technological recession between 2020 and 2040, reducing global pollution levels, humanity is still facing monumental existential threats. Climate change has turned into climate disaster. Its effects are irreversible and dangerously unpredictable. Hurricanes, tornadoes, droughts, floods, natural catastrophes are growing in strength and frequency across the continent, leveling entire regions. Access to clean water is becoming increasingly more scarce, as well as fertile land. Hunger and starvation still reaps a bloody human harvest in Asia and Africa, where corporations had no interest in building vertical hydroponic farms. Meanwhile, advances in cyber modification have given rise to a new problem, cyberpsychosis. And though we've been aware of cyberpsychosis for over half a century, we know that the incidence of cyberpsychosis are inextricably linked to a person's level of implantation. We still do not know why some are more prone to carrying out violent attacks than others. Let's not also forget the more serious issue of mass inequality, record high crime rates, including in places like Night City, and social unrest linked to immigration in almost every corner of the world. So I ask you again, look around. You see all these problems in Night City already. Maybe you're standing in the shadow of a mega building and you think, Night City is Night City. The rest of the world's problems don't affect me, right? Right? I got a spotted tank top. And a spotted flexi membrane bustier. Trauma. Whose room is... Is this somebody's... Oh, I've been here. This is where I came from, where the meeting took place. Yeah, I just came from here and I'm still finding new stuff. And I've been in here, and that just leads here. Nope, not this time.
Forget something?
No, just looking around. I forgot your O'Dickin whiskey, and your bounce back MK1, and your Ventricule, whatever. Because this place isn't actually that big. So I can't get a... Well, I do have a map of the place. In the corner here. So what's the red? I don't think I'm supposed to go back there. Sorry. Oh, there was something down there. See, I know that symbol pertains to her. I just don't know what the red means. And I keep finding more stuff. Mind me, guys, just continuing to look around here. What does the green mean? So you have a green on the map there. Look right ahead of me. Looks like her. And then there's a green... here. Are those, like, I don't know. It's pertaining to certain people. I gotta look it up, what the icons mean on the map. Mini-map, sorry. I like the music in this place. I've been here. I haven't been in here. Oops. What is that? It looks like I'm using the bathroom. I'm in the man's bathroom. Oh, am I gonna be bald again? I have hair! Yay! I'm not gonna... I think the mirrors are very graphical intensive. Oh, dead body? Or is he asleep?
Hey, watch it.
Oh, you're awake. You're alive. Just trying to bring you back to life, and I succeeded. Titanium fitted polyamide combat boots. Oh, safe area? So is this not a safe area? Huh.
Live your fucking life, hon, cause tomorrow ain't coming.
Somehow you said that without ever moving your mouth. Jackie's right there. So what I want to do is I want to look... I Action blocked. Oh, I can't change anything right now. Because I'm wearing this. Special. Okay. So whenever I'm done with the Militech suit, I have a lot better... basically everything. Better outerwear, better shirt, pants I think as well, better boots. You're not Jackie. Okay. Never mind. So where does this go then? Is there another level? Oh, I can go to the roof? I have a feeling the roof might be a dangerous place. Clothes, lots of clothes. Are we going to heaven? Look at this, it's all white. We're still going up. How high is the roof? Wow. Well, I figured there'd be more things to loot or something up here. Well, there are a few things to get. Candles? Someone's having a little party up here. Another stapler. Alright. There's something here. Oh, I can climb up. I got an abstract painting. What the hell is a painting doing up there? Is it full under junk? Yeah. An expression of an artist's inner self or a computer's procedural generation algorithm. Well, that narrows it down. Alright, where else can we go? There's just roof and afterlife.
After the break, what quality is most important when hiring a personal bodyguard for your child?
Bodyguard for your child. Safe area. Safe burrito. Okay, they went down. There's something there by you. I can't get it. I want whatever that thing is. I think it's a stress ball thingy.
There's work, but not for you.
I got work. I got big work here coming up.
Yeah.
Alright, stay tuned for the next episode, guys, when we actually go on this heist to go get the chip. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.